Hey, I'm Thomas Mahler. I'm the creative director at Moon Studios.
Hey, I'm Gennady, and I'm a production and technical director, and both of us are the founders of Moon.
We are working on our new project, which is called No Rest for the Wicked.
It's the biggest thing we've ever tried to achieve. It's the most ambitious one. It's something we've been working up to since 2016. We're full steam ahead, making sure we're ready for an early access launch, and also going to be working a lot on this game for many, many years to come.
We want to do something completely different, where we give the player ultimate control over their character. It should be super precise, right? So that you can do things like, oh, if an enemy swings his sword, right, I can jump back. I can precisely time that so that he misses me by one pixel. That's why we changed the controls and everything.
It's a very intuitive thing for us as well of just, I don't think we would want it any other way, especially with all the verticality that we have in the game, you know, jumping and climbing. And it's a very different level design compared to just any other action RPG. And it's much more Metroidvania. It's much more of, you know, creating these shortcuts, creating these interconnected moments, having something that you can really get lost in a good way. And with a point and click model, how do you really make that natural? You know, how do you make that convenient? I think it would be very, very difficult. And it just doesn't fit our DNA.
Our combat system is very similar to how a Street Fighter or Mortal Kombat and so on would work, meaning that we have a timeline. We actually figure out, hey, what are the actions that we want to perform, right? And then we tell our animators, hey, make me an animation that does this. And then we have to chop it all up, right? And kind of like understand, hey, on this frame, this has to happen. Then on this frame, this has to happen. Then on this frame, this has to happen, right? And we have hundreds, if not thousands, of moves and so on in the game. So that's extremely laborious, but you need that kind of precision if you want to pull off this kind of combat, right? The animations really have to matter. You have to let the animation basically drive everything. Hopefully, like, I think the players will absolutely love that we went through this crazy thing of like making sure every weapon is unique.
The combat is a lot more advanced, a lot more tactical. Every single move is a lot more meaningful, and there is a really beautiful skill progression that the player can feel. You know, it's not just the character progression and loot progression, RPG progression, and, you know, upgrading the weapons, getting better stats with weapons, getting better stats for your character, getting better stats for your town, because, you know, the town building aspect in this game is basically your own extra character that you can progress. But it's really about also feeling that your skill is improving and getting that very, very nice kick of satisfaction of knowing that, oh, now I know how to walk around this boss, and I've figured out that I can actually just run to the side instead of having to roll all the time or spam the rolls, or I can find these openings a lot better, or I understand how I can use the additional combos coming out of a roll or coming out of the roll attack or using these specials. And all of that creates this depth where you're maxing out the game not only on the numbers level, which is what ARPGs are really good at, but it's also creating an addictive loop on a mechanics level and maxing out that progression of, I am a badass, I'm getting better at this game, I'm learning and I'm improving. And I think that is a very addictive combination. No Rest for the Wicked is coming to early access on Steam on April 18th.